Imagine averaging 28 points, 14 rebounds, and 8 assists while shooting 56% from the field and 34% from 3 and not being the favorite to win the MVP award. Russell Westbrook averaged 3 more points, 4 less rebounds, and 2 more assists while shooting 14.5% worse from the field and won the award. Now, Jokic does have to compete with Joel Embiid, and I'll admit, he's having a super season, as I spoke about in a previous video. However, Jokic is perhaps having the best offensive season ever. Yeah, I'm talking about a Steph Curry in 2016 caliber season, and no one is talking about it. I mean, I feel like I'm going crazy out here. So I thought it would be a good idea to make a video in which I make the case that Nikola Jokic should be the season's MVP. Let's start with his passing, because that's the part of his game that's the most freakish. He's a high-level operator from the top of the key. He can find guys in the post, cutters, and shooters in the corner. He loves these little 1-2s. He operates pick and rolls like the best of them too. He is an elite post playmaker. And if you do decide to double him, he will make you pay. His accuracy on his passes, finding the slightest of holes, is remarkable. He makes it look like he's operating at a higher level than everyone else. And the vision to see these openings is at an all-time level, never mind the ability to execute these passes as well. The decision making is always lightning quick. While he gets a lot of touches, he doesn't hold onto the ball for a long time. This helps keep the offense fluid and encourages motion, which is what most great modern NBA offenses are built around. He loves working out of these dribble handoffs, and having cutters buzzing around him opens up so many opportunities for him and is a headache to defend. He's also just huge, so handoffs are that little bit more effective for him. If defenders overplay the handoff, he can slide these passes to cutters going back the other way. His passing on the move is also outstanding. Then there's the truly crazy stuff. Yeah, he completely fools the defense with his eyes by looking at Austin Rivers, and that gets Will Barton open on the perimeter. There are also a bunch of no-lookers I could show you right now. Here he just throws a couple fake passes, and that creates a wide open lane for Monte Morris to get this easy bucket. I mean, here he just slices through a crowd of Celtics to get to Jeff Green in the corner. People don't talk about this enough, but Jokic is an elite scorer. He's averaging 38.4 points per 100, which is 6th in the league, on plus 9 effective field goal percentage. So basically, he's scoring the 6th most points in the league and is 9% more efficient than the league average. This is what that looks like graphically. For reference, the 5 guys ahead of him scoring are Embiid, Giannis, Ja, Trey, and Luka. Here are their relative effective field goal percentages. Embiid, -0.02. Giannis, +3.4. Ja, +0.04. Trey, -0.03. And Luka's at -0.13. So Jokic is pretty much in a different universe compared to these guys when it comes to efficiency. He loves getting into the post and can hit guys with drop steps, fadeaways, and hook shots. He'll spin baseline to get to the basket, or the other way for fadeaways. His feet are so light and ballerina-like when he's in the paint. Get him in the post and he can just beast guys after an early seal. Here he seals his man and immediately goes to that soft righty hook. He's a problem for switching defenses. He'll back down smaller players and it's just too fast for the big guys. Here the Blazers switch and Jokic just shoots right over Anthony Simons, who ends up on him. Bigger guys go under against him a lot of the time because they just don't want to have to deal with chasing him over screens, and that leaves his three ball wide open. He's also basically next gen Dirk from mid-range. The three ball makes him a threat from all three levels and basically impossible to guard. Give him an inch of space and he'll launch threes all over your head. He loves this area at the top of the key, but that's not all. He'll even hit threes off of movement like a wing. I mean, look at the step back. This man is basically a giant and is engaging in this sort of behavior. I mean, it's just unfair. He'll use this threat to attack closeouts, not with your usual speed or explosion, but with pure brute force at times. That doesn't mean he's just a human battering ram. Here he just blows by Valanciunas, and clearly Jonas was surprised by the burners in the big serve. The Joker will often start in the high post, pass out, and then relocate to the open space on the perimeter. This spacing pulls big men out of the paint, which makes it easier for everyone else to finish at the basket, and is a big reason the Nuggets are the fourth most efficient team finishing at the basket. The two-man game mentioned earlier with his passing can be reversed to get him scoring as well. He has a little handoff with Monte Morris here, and he sets a great screen, which forces Jonas Valanciunas to engage Morris, which allows Jokic to slip to the other elbow, and as we've discussed earlier, he is cash from there. Then they run the same play from the reverse direction, and this time Jokic takes Valanciunas on off the dribble and gets the easy bucket. He's a threat in the pick and roll as a roller too. He'll pull up a mid-range as well if big men give him that space. Here he's rolling in the pick and roll and fakes the jumper before floating the shot over Poku. Then he does the exact same thing, but this time spins and throws his little hook shot up. He's effective at scoring off the glass too. Despite not being an outlier athlete, his size and soft hands mean he's a threat of putbacks. This gives his teammates freedom to get shots up, knowing that if they miss, there's still potential for an efficient offensive possession waiting right there. So, after all of this, do I think Nikola Jokic should be the MVP as of right now? I'd probably say so. I don't want to discount what Joel Embiid is doing, but what we're seeing from Jokic is special. Like, the stuff that goes in history books. One thing I am sure of though is that he deserves more respect. This is an all-time season he's having, and I think we should just sit back and appreciate it before it's over. Well, that was all for this video. If you did enjoy, please put like and tap that like button. And until next time, it has been your boy, Zachary McAllister. Have a good day.